A ganglion cyst is a fluid-filled sac, most commonly seen in the wrist, with additional sites at the base of a finger and at the top of the end joint of a finger or thumb. We aren't quite sure what causes a ganglion cyst. There's speculation. We think it's degeneration of soft tissue leading to formation or leaking of fluid very similar to joint fluid. A patient will often present with a bump in the wrist and they're unhappy with the appearance of the bump, and sometimes they have pain in association with the bump. Similar to the bumps that occur at the base of the finger and at the top joint of the finger. Non-surgical options for treating ganglion cysts include observation. If there's some discomfort, temporary wrist splinting or over-the-counter pain medication on a very temporary basis. Aspiration, which means putting a needle into the sac and withdrawing fluid. And then surgery, where we incise through the skin and take out the sac. The timing of the surgery depends on how complicated the operation is in the way of how deep is the sac, how extensive is the sac. So it's difficult to put a time frame on this, but I would say in general, it takes about 30 minutes to remove a cyst. After removing a ganglion cyst, it's hoped that a patient returns to their pre-surgical functionality and hopefully no pain. There are situations though where residual pain is expected, and that's, for example, someone with some arthritis in the joint. By removing the bump or the ganglion, you're not necessarily going to help the pain. Getting back to what patients like to do in life, their functionality depends on a lot of factors. Personally, I try to get people back as quickly as possible. So for example, if I take a cyst out of the base of a finger or the end joint of a finger, I let them move the fingers right away. I let them get back on the keyboard right away. I'd let them get back into the gym after early wound healing in about a week. If they're a swimmer, I usually hold for 2 to 3 weeks so there's no dehiscence or falling apart of a wound. At the wrist level, it takes a little bit longer. I usually let people, if they're weightlifting, get back into the gym after 3 to 4 weeks. If they're swimmers, I let them get back into the water after 2 to 3 weeks again, worrying about the wounds falling apart if you get into chlorinated water too soon.